I'd like to introduce a number of our politicians who are here with us today. Each of them will have a couple of minutes to speak to you. So welcome them all and enjoy your day. Thanks again so much for being part of this.
We invite everyone to participate in Safe Boating Week. Enjoy this day, enjoy this wonderful boating season, and let me hand it over to Assemblyman Andrew Rea.
Thanks, Mark. I'd like to thank the town of Huntington for allowing us to use these fields. They're in great shape. It is Safe Boating Week, so by all means, take that to heart. I'd like to thank the council for another successful event. Seems to be growing and doubling in size every year. I'm proud to be a part of it. I'm the one running the radio control boats over in the corner, so come on over, have a little fun.
Thank you all for being here. I want to thank all the merchants for participating, and thank Jackie Martin and the council for another wonderful Safe Boating Week. So please be careful out there, be safe on your boats, have fun.
It is a great day to be out, walking around, looking at all the vendors. A special thanks has to go out to Jackie for doing such a great job and pulling this together. Thank you, Jackie, and the greater Yachting Council. We thank you very much, and we look forward to working side by side with you to make it even better next year. God bless you. All have a safe boating week and a safe boating summer, and we will see you soon on the water. Thank you.
So thank you guys very much for coming. This is a big effort to get this underway, and I want to thank my committee members and the Boating Council and the town of Huntington for all they did to make this day possible. Our lead sponsor, American Marine, give them a huge round of applause. They're dead center with three beautiful boats. Northport Yacht Club, Centerport Yacht Club, our Admiral sponsor, Daniel Gale Sotheby's, and Captain sponsor, Lucky to Live Here Realty. So thank you all so very, very much for being so great to us to help us produce this event.
Susan, and this is Deb. We have shops at the Shops of Sweet Pieces in Huntington. It's located at 1038 New York Avenue in Huntington, and we repurpose things. I change things from what they used to be, give them a new life. I make signs, and Deb makes jewelry out of old jewelry.
I would love to take old vintage pieces and reimagine them into other things and do some beading. And we're having fun here because of the beautiful weather we're having,
and we're happy to be here.
I've been boating for about 40 years, and 10 boats later, I have a lot of excess stuff that I'm selling, and people buy little things here and there that I don't need. It's sort of surplus for me. Woodco Boating Club up on West Shore Road. We have 72 slips and maybe 8 moorings, and we're full, always full. It's a great club. It's a social club. They're fun people. Everybody's got the same kind of complaints. It costs money and so on, but that's what we do.
Hi, I'm Connie Jacobs. I own North Sea Navigator, and it's a business I took over from my dad years ago. And we do mainly compass repair, installation, and calibration. So I come to the boat and use a sun azimuth or a tank, a tower, and we make sure that we put the compass back where it should be magnetically, because all the other information, you know, instruments around the boat, the VHF radio, stereo, different instruments can cause deviation. It pretty much starts when the boat is new and it's never been done before. You know, boat dealers don't calibrate compasses. They make sure that the stove works, the toilet flushes, and everything else, but they don't care about the compass. So when the boat is new, it should be done. And then whenever you have equipment change, whenever you replace things, take things off, it can affect the compass. I work all over the island. I do the Coast Guards here. I do Staten Island ferries, tugboats, private boats. I go as far as Philadelphia Coast Guard, Cape May. So I'm all over the place.
My name's Steve Kuhn. I've been a clammer on the Great South Bay off of Sable and Bayport for 50 years. And in 1971, I designed and came up with the Clam Power t-shirt. And the design took off like wildfire. There were people all over the place clamming. And it kind of faded out as the clamming faded out. What happened, people copied my silkscreen. My sons and I brought it back about 10 years ago, and we've kind of reintroduced it. And we've met tons and tons of people all over the place that used to have this t-shirt and love the water, and it brings back great memories to them. Oh, no, I've worked on the Great South Bay. I've worked in Staten Island on the South Shore. This is Huntington. I clammed over here a couple times, but it's quite a commute for me, and it's a lot easier to do it when you're close to home. This is a great event. We've been here since the original 3 years ago. People have been really, really nice and accommodating, and it's a beautiful place over here.
Squeeze box, she wears on her chest. When daddy comes home late, he never gets no rest, but she playing all night. When the music's all right, oh, mama's gotta squeeze my hand and give her sleep at night. Well, the kids don't eat and the dog don't sleep. There's no escape from the music in the whole day. She's playing all night and the music's all right.